With COVID-19 cases and hospitalizations on the rise here, conversations over mask mandates are now heating up. Denver 7's Ivan Rodriguez shows us which communities could be on the verge of requiring people to mask up.
After dropping off her 14-year-old daughter to hang out with friends, Emily Smith decided to cut through the park.
We made a really big deal about masks, hand sanitizers, stay 6 feet away.
In Golden, all parks, city buildings, and trails require people to wear masks, something not everyone is sticking to.
For me, it's disappointing when I see people without their masks.
By the end of this week, City Council could issue an emergency ordinance requiring masks across Golden.
And the idea behind it is really to get higher compliance in some of our areas where we see a lot more people, a lot more tourists, a lot of residents out and about.
And it makes me nervous when we have people coming here and not wearing masks, that our small town could be overwhelmed with COVID cases.
Aurora is another city in favor of a mask mandate.
A mask mandate may be inconvenient for a lot of people, and I get the civil libertarians don't like it. But I think in terms of the options that are before us, as far as bringing the COVID rate down and opening up this economy, I'll take a mask mandate.
On Wednesday, Tri-County Health will make a decision on masks, but only for Adams and Arapahoe counties. Aurora's Mayor Mike Kaufman would rather it be done across the board.
People cross municipal boundaries every day. As a core, in as a function of their jobs, of shopping, or school, and so just having this patchwork in terms of a mandate doesn't make sense to me.
I think, unfortunately, a lot of people need to be told, and when we leave it as an option, you have some people who choose to comply and some people don't who don't.
When asked if a state or regional mask mandate was coming down, the governor's office says it supports counties' decisions on mask rules since they're the ones on the front lines. Ivan Rodriguez, Denver 7.